So the very first match then of the WTT Finals Men Doha 2023, the showpiece finale in prospect here to what's been an amazing season in world table tennis once again. And what a match here, Guy McCree and Fraser Riley with you to take you through the action. What a match here in Doha to begin. Four in the world against six in the world here. Liang Jingquan against Lim Win Ru here. There are no easy matches in world table tennis, and this is a case in point from the get-go.
It's, for me, literally the toss of a coin. I mean, we know that Lim Win Ru had the hand injury. It seemed to become kind of present against Liang in Xinjiang. You can see he's still strapped in that area, however, it didn't seem to affect him in Frankfurt, did it? Oh my word.
It's effective play early on from Liang.
How effortless Lim Win Ru made that look there. Good containing play from Liang, actually playing the backhand block from the wide forehand. Some improv there, courtesy of the class of Lin away from the table.
Well, he started well here, Liang, the reverse pendulum, of course, and then following up in fine style. I mean, this is the thing, isn't it, with... You were saying yourself, in terms of the head-to-head, that Liang's won on both occasions, but you feel Lin's got a shot here, and there'll be a lot of respect from Liang to the other end of the table here. And the start that he's made seems to back that up, Fraser.
Yeah. We'll see if the third time can be the charm here for Lim Win Ru. He is playing outstanding table tennis, and for me, really could medal at the Olympic Games. Nearly did, of course, in Tokyo, but, I mean, he's come on leaps and bounds physically. His weight transfer, his power against a slower ball, not relying on just feeding off the pace anymore, Lim Win Ru. Saw it in the first attack, but Liang, we know, is so good at containing and redirecting. Here, just sponged up the attack, actually with more of a counter down the short side, flustered Lin.
Three, four.
Trying the bottle challenge serve there. Fast down the line with backspin and side spin. Got to be very decisive on the receive there. The net exposing the tactic.
Back to the stock play there, following up. Tight here, the opening 8 points shared between these two.
I mean, that is probably the most iconic flick in the world of table tennis. Lim Win Ru's Chiquita. Liang, like he did in the last encounter, using the reverse pendulum to wide forehand to try and stop Lim Win Ru from being able to play the power flick as easily. It's a suffocating serve that Liang is demonstrating here. Wang Hao. Iconic penhold sensei in the corner for Liang, and I think for probably every Chinese men player here.
Five, six.
One floats long, puts Lim back to just one adrift here, almost through to the second towel break of the game.
Seven,
ooh.
Five.
Yeah, look of frustration from Silent Assassin as he moves through to that towel break, trailing by two here. Now, it's just fascinating. You touched on some of the points already here about the flick, the wristy play of Lim Win Ru. We know all about it, but to see here Liang Jingquan, how clever he is as well in trying to formulate a consistent response to that. Oh, he caresses that away.
Effortless, seemingly anyway, there from Liang. But it's the combination. Sometimes he might want to bait Lim Win Ru. Sometimes he might want Lim Win Ru to flick, but you've got to think, okay, what am I probably going to get next? And be ready.
Good run together here, six of the last eight, and extends that here. Strong out of the towel break, Liang. So a four-point lead, 2 points, of course, from the opening game here, the Chinese.
Some raw power there. You can see if you take on that backhand flick from the forehand side, you're leaving that wide backhand exposed. The hand flick there from the middle still paid the price. Good angle from Lin. Shovel surf here.
Alive to it, Liang. And Lin is in a spot of bother here now. Game points, five of them here. Four indeed, and that is the first one that's taken. So some work to do here. Slime assassin here, Lin Wenru. Game down in this first match of the day in Doha to Liang Jingquan. It's best of five here. Just we saw reflecting back a bit, Fraser, get your insights. The second half, if you like, of that opening game. See maybe a little bit of the head-to-head going on, but more to the point about Liang Jingquan and what a clever player he is,
yeah.
What he can do at the table.
Oh, look at that as well there. Amazing winner. But yeah, I mean, Lin Wenru got off to a fantastic start in game one, but it seemed to be red rag to a bull. Liang seemed to remind himself, OK, revert to basics, have the strong fundamentals, and he was able to handcuff Lin, especially in the serve and receive. You can see here, what he's doing is, with that serve, with that reverse pendulum, and then the opener, he's basically asking Lin Wenru to make a major compound movement really early doors, testing the irregular footwork pattern.
You often make the point, you've made the point through the season in the WTT series, you said about rhythm, about breaking rhythm, being one of the fundamentals, if you like, particularly at the elite level, the top end of the sport. And that's something, isn't it, that Liang, as this match goes on, that he's testing there more and more.
Mm. Look at that. Did really well to brush up that half long, Lin, but just really trying to make things uncomfortable, Liang. Look at that. I mean, the ball, so close to the edge, but the awareness of the silent assassin there. Second nature.
Struggling a little bit, despite there taking that point behind his service at the moment, Lin, only winning about 50% of the points.
I'd be interested to see how the match will go, Guy, if Lin can do better against that reverse pendulum. That was a cutting push receive with the forehand there. That was lovely.
Oh, that is surprising. Done all of it, he set it up over the table, on top of the table, a rare error from Liang.
He just missed an absolute howler. I mean, 9 in 10, at least, I made that. He went for a really, really acute angle with the finish. Serve there. So suffocating, isn't it? It's not nice as a righty playing against a lefty, never mind a lefty of Lin Wenru's calibre. Of course, they're rarer, less common, so they get more practice against righties than righties get against lefties.
Yeah, statistically, just the case, yeah. If you like, these finals is about, if you like, reflecting on the improvements and otherwise that players have made through the season. I mean, Fraser, you and I are privileged to commentate at so many of these events. It's funny, looking at Lin Wenru here, And the mentality and the body language.
Yeah.
I mean, you talked about him in terms of his game, how he's become stronger. But also mentally, in terms of body language, what he gives you, gives to the opponent.
Mm. Yeah.
Seeing if this second game goes on, it could be a factor.
Absolutely. He blurs the lines in some ways, because you think of an athlete as a more of an alpha character, but Lin Minru is so quiet, reserved, timid, almost in some ways. He lets the table tennis do the talking, but he doesn't give you much to feed off vocally. Liang is one of the most emotional players in the Chinese national team.
Saying all that from Lin, there is a bit of frustration coming through here with the body language here. See it again here, Fraser.
But look at that, into the middle. Got exactly the ball that he wanted next. The passive bit of play out of Liang. Couldn't put the icing on the cake. He's miscontacting a few of these forehands with the top edge of the racket. The shovel serve digging him out of some trouble. You like that one, don't you?
Yes, indeed.
It's tasty.
Indeed, looking to dig himself out of a hole here. And he needs to as well. We often talk about the best of five dynamic. Someone of Liang's caliber, you go two down. Chances really recede from there. Yeah. Together a couple of moments here. Get himself back level. Chances increase.
It's another delightful receive. Sometimes it just takes a little bit of getting used to really get that full calibration on each shot.
Back with the service here. Within 2 points from leveling up. Well, it was Liang who made the strong finish to game one. Is Lin going to respond here in kind? Mm. 3 game points now.
Better receive there from Liang, playing with some greasy spin. But I'm liking this change of service from Lin. With the shovel serve, the ball kind of stalls for a split second. It's going to give him an extra bit of time on the third ball, and also basically gives the potential for Liang to overthink the receive. You'd be surprised how fast at this level a short serve can actually be, but Lin here is slowing things down initially to create a kind of juxtaposition, a shock and awe effect.
Two have gone now for Lin. One remains. And now the timeout called here. Nothing doing there. Liang stands tall, stands tough, and for the first time, I think we're going to go a few times, Fraser, these 3 days. We go into a 10-all situation in a game. These are key moments here. Oh. 3 game points he's had.
Yeah.
Now a 2-point clear. Winning margin required with the serve rotating here, for those of you not aware, from tens. Massive moments in this knockout.
Well, you can't afford to freeze like an iceberg. This could have and would be a titanic loss for Lin Minru in this game. It feels like a must win in this best of five. That timeout at 10-9 was definitely not really for tactics, more trying to affect Liang's mentality. Oh, but what a serve, what a fooling serve there from Liang.
Yeah, I mean, it got Lin here, as you can see, in all sorts of bother. I mean, it was almost like a tennis slice going on there, rather than a table tennis shot there from Lin, because of the quality of the service. Really duped him. That's 4 game points now.
Gets on his tippy toes there, Lin. The racket angle near horizontal to counteract that topspin. Brilliant timing. taking the backhand a little bit later than the forehand at this level. Starting the shot from under the armpit of the free arm. Snip and tuck, isn't it?
Now you talk about Liang Jingkun, what a competitor he is. You see it here, 7-10, 10-11, 11-12, all those occasions he stepped up. And as you said, Fraser, these are key moments in the match right here, right now. So many qualities about these top Chinese stars, and we're seeing here and then right here from Liang. What a game this would be to steal. Wang Hao, he did that quite a few times, of course, in his illustrious career, the 2009 world champion. Ability to come from behind and take games. Oh, but not there. Lin's turn to step up. Second game this is turning into.
Just can't take your eyes off it. What a scorching, torching backhand there from Lin. Both of them, but look at that, just painting the table. And even Liang there puffs his cheeks out and says, fair play.
Oh, beautiful control feeling there from Liang.
Yeah, the chop block tempted Lin into going for an all cards on the table forehand. But it's the composure. I mean, we talk about personalities in sport. And this is an alpha bit of play from the beast from the Far East.
Oh, yeah, now that stamp. He knew it. He had it there. He literally had it.
He did. But it seemed like that, didn't it? But look at this from Lin, out of the middle. And that was clever. He's a bit further away, so he plays with slower spin. If he plays a hard shot there, it'll be easy for Liang to use that pace and guide it out wide. The alarm bells rang. Must admit, he has had a bit more of the fortune, Liang. The top edge to help him get back to juice in game two off the forehand. Apologises there for a bit more. But you can't say it's not favouring the brave.
His third game point. Remember, Lin has had five of them. Again, misses out there. Slightly surprising. Oh, well, it's what's on the line here. This showpiece occasion. And even more so than that, just in the matchup itself, both here feeling the pressure. Both have had multiple chances here to take this second game. And it goes on. ...15 points apiece now, this second game.
So after winning the point, Liang calls the timeout.
Yeah, it's a fourth game point chance for Liang Jingkun. There we go. Seen it so often, the timeout from Wang Hao, the chance to. I'm just interested, Fraser, because you look at that, Lin Wenru, five game points in succession. And then Liang there needing four overall. But about the nature of the timeout. Just that feeling, as you say, unison of the player and coach, because Wang Hao in that position doesn't call it when Liang has his first opportunity or second or third. It's the timing, isn't it? And a feeling, a grasp of the situation that's paramount.
It was probably more of a cruel to be kind, more of a kind of, come on now, get this done, you know. Come on, don't delay this anymore.
Sweep. Needs a few more of those, a few more sweep moments here. This is, remember, he's never beaten Liang, the two previous meetings, two down here. He had his chances, though, in that second game.
Did. He'll be hoping it will be a kind of Patrick Franziska in the round of 32 of the champion story, where it can come from 2-0 down in the first round and then just blow everyone out the park. Oh, sweet as a nut there, that forehand flick. Time to perfection, the dainty touch, and then flatter as it has to be with the forehand flick.
This is very good from the silent assassin here, calmly, quietly going about his work into the towel break.
This is something that we really see and learn from the pros, how the body's doing all the work, but the head stays so still and low. Helps you get that control and awareness. Paramount into playing this quality of shot on such a consistent basis.
This is. It was the point of no return for Lin Wenru here, a game he has to win. Best of five, but going about his work in fine style.
Immaculate. This is what I expected a bit more of, to be honest. I saw this personally as more of an uphill battle for Liang over the entirety of the match, particularly because of the last performance we've seen from Lin. And now.
Well, I mean, the run he's putting together here, yeah, it does remind you of what happened at the event, the Champions event in Frankfurt, how he beat Wang Chuqin and Ma Long back-to-back, and just the nature of his run, his road to gold, as we called it. Social media team put that together, if you haven't seen that. Yeah. Lin Wenru's run to his biggest career title. And this is what he was doing in Germany. And this is a crushing third game. 9 game points on Liang. Oh, and the angle there with the angle, the arm there to take a point back. He's been dusted aside here in this third game, Liang, so far. All about trying to get some momentum back in his favour here. Second game point. I mean, you're never out, of course, in this sport, but at this level from 10-1,
yeah,
the odds are stacked against you, it's fair to say. But it's more, I think, about looking to reset ahead of the fourth game for him here. Trying to take as many points as he can and build for that likely fourth game to come here in Doha. Indeed is where we are going. Very well there, actually going into the elbow direction, shot placement from Liang. Very good to begin game four.
Start of the new leaf, now getting vocal. It's a 2-2, I mean, imagine that, knowing you were 2-0 up against the man who's removed brick after brick. China, table tennis, the Great Wall, if you will, have had to tread across it more carefully because of this young man. And for Liang, I mean, getting wins like this is so important, especially because of the couple of losses that he had this season to the likes of Jorgic and Shelbury. It's purring now.
Yeah, he's going through a very good patch here, if you like, a purple patch. He likes the Lin Wenru, the colour purple, because of course that's the branding of the Champions tier of event. He had that fantastic week in Frankfurt. And he's looking to bring the heat and fire his way back into this. And the colour scheming of these finals. Ferocious play again from Lin.
Paid the price though, look at that. Liang going to the open space, anticipating so well.
This is good. It just goes back and forth at this level. Of course, you get these little runs. Rare that you get runs. You talked about that 4 against 6 in the world.
Where's the wiggle room? To find that, you've got to come up with something special, but the quality of every opponent you're going to be up against here, they're going to adapt. You've got to constantly reinvent yourself throughout the match. Yeah. Lynn there, playing with extra spin.
Yeah, needed that, having lost 6 of the last 8 points. Lynn, take that point into the tail break. Just stay in touch. Just a gorgeous angle. I'm going to see a few of those in this event. They do it for fun, these elites. Make it look so, so easy.
They're at a stage, and in fact, they've actually got to this level by not thinking about the shot too much. You know, train hard, play easy. That's the motto. And it's spoken in volumes, as you quite rightly say. Here, as usual, really. Not much shed from Lynn in this game. Hasn't been able to really express himself too much because of Liang's quality. Look at the contortion. I mean, for a big guy, he is as fit as a butcher's dog.
Yeah, is this the decisive push here being made towards the quarterfinal for Liang Jingquan?
So active, bouncing, making those minor adjustments with the footwork that make all the difference, keeping the bat high and the timing point early, imposing himself well. Liang saying to himself there, maybe I should have taken on the forehand push instead. Hindsight is a terrible thing. It's almost like Lynn is able to suck the optimism out of the opponent. Big point here.
Razor sharp into that tail break from Liang to put the lead back up to 4, 3 points away now from progress. Chinese.
Can he put the nail in the coffin? A lukewarm ball from Lin on the receive there. Perhaps some nerves, some indecisiveness, or some indecisiveness because of the nerves. Better clarity of mind there with that third ball kill. Disguised it with, I think, a bit of topspin, and Liang popped it up, paid the price. But it's not been the power, it's not been that alone from Liang. It's been the placement. And this is something that we sometimes forget about Liang because of the seismic waves that he makes with the slinging shots that he plays. Actually, his craftiness, the subtle changes that he makes to tie up Lin Minru here and limit the amount of weapons that he can bring out of the arsenal.
Yeah, it's been a smart performance. He's almost there now, Liang. And he is there now. He's the first winner of this WTT Finals Men 2023 here in...